Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about Hive and its MetaStore. As you are aware that Hive is one of the SQL solutions that are available with Hadoop. That is, whenever you want to save your data, you can use SQL queries and load and delete the data from Hive. However, the data is saved in the SDFS directory. But what about the metadata? Where is our metadata stored in Hive? So let's explore. First, you need to open the Linux command line interface. Click on this button. As soon as you click on that button, you will get the command line interface. Here you need to type Hive and press enter. This will take you inside the Hive shell where you can write the SQL queries or you can say the HQL queries, Hive query language. In the time we are connecting to Hive, let's see how we can explore the MetaStore where Hive's metadata is stored. For that, you need to search for a file which is your hivesite.xml. Inside this configuration file, we have the JDO property which tells us where the Hive MetaStore lies. Select this file path, copy it, and you can open it in VI Shell or any other editor in Linux. Search for the JDO option, and here you can see the JDO or the Java Database object points to the MySQL. That means the Hive MetaStore is a MySQL data store which is installed in the local machine, and this is the driver name. Here you can also see the username and the password. So using this username and password, you can simply log in into your MySQL, which is the Hive MetaStore. To connect to MySQL, now you can write the command MySQL space hyphen username, which is Hive, and hyphen password. Press enter. It will ask you for the password. Give the password, which is Cloudera, and you are inside the MySQL shell. Here you can type in the command show databases, and you can see we have a MetaStore database. Use this MetaStore. Now you can show tables. Now if you look here, these are all the Hive MetaStore tables which contains the metadata about Hive, not the data. Data is stored in SDFS separately, but this is the metadata which is stored in the MySQL. You can look here, TBLS, this is a table which contains the detail about all the tables that are created in Hive. Similarly, you can have all the information of the partitions that are created in Hive, all the buckets that are created in Hive inside this bucketing column. You can have all the information about Hive logs, indexes, and so on. Let's see it in practice. Now I am inside Hive and I want to create a table. So before that, let's see if there is any table that exists inside the TBLS table. So currently in MetaStore, there is no table. That means I don't have any table created in Hive. See, when I say show tables in Hive, there is no table. So let's create a table, say a product table, with one single column ID as integer. Now this table is created in Hive and all the data with this table will get saved in SDFS. Now let's see if this entry is made inside the MetaStore. See, in MySQL, in this MetaStore table TBLS, we have an entry that this table, which is product table, managed table, which is an internal type, is created by the user Cloudera at this epoch time. Till now you have seen that whenever we create any table in Hive, a metadata entry is created in a MySQL database under the MetaStore database. Now let's see what will happen if I drop this table. Now if I select data from my TBLS table, I again get an empty set. So that means whenever you are making any DDL changes in Hive, they are getting reflected in the MySQL Metastore or any other Metastore. Say for example, if you have Derby database, so that will be used as your Metastore. Make sure that you are never doing any entry directly in your Metastore because that may corrupt your Hive. So always make sure you drop or create tables from the Hive console and not making any entry directly at the backend. Thanks for watching.